I'm Jan Imes with Betallic. Welcome to bDesign Tutorials. Today's design is about organic decor and how to add eye-catching texture with prints for extra visual punch in your designs. So first, let me share how this example design was assembled. Two base plates and poles on either side. No frame in the top. It's not needed for a design this small because if it's tied tightly and set against a wall to use like a photo frame, it doesn't need a frame. However, in a large area or high traffic area, you do need to use a full arch frame. Let me talk about design balance very quickly before we get started. Design balance means because we have a lot of balloons here at the top, and we have some smaller space on either side just to add interest, a little rhythm and motion, I need something a little bit bigger at the bottom to balance it out. We've just simply attached the same elements to the pole at the bottom and at the top, and then with these same elements mixed in along either side. Let's get started on how to create this design. I'm using Premium Balloon Accessories Cool Air 4, which is a bonus because it has a foot pedal, which leaves my hands free, has a lot of power also. And I'm just going to use it to inflate the printed balloons to show you how to get the best effect out of that print. It's going to give me more shine. And the print looks bigger. Same with the confetti. Push it down. And I'm forcing the air into the top part rather than letting it start at the bottom. And now I'm going to show you how to double stuff and inflate. You can do it with a straw, but I have a click-click sizer, which is really handy to do this with. I'm just going to slide the inside balloon over the top. And then just pull the graffiti balloon over the top. And now make sure that you have the tip all the way down so that you're filling both balloons. If you want to give it an extra oomph, you can cover up one of the openings. What a great effect. For clusters, you can make typically 4, 3, 5, depending on the space that you want to fill. I'm going to show you how to attach it to a base plate and pole. You simply slide a cluster in and wrap one over the other. That's it. And then continue to add clusters. As you go, kind of adjust so that your textures and prints are not repeated on top of each other. Now, I'm going to show you, if you're not using a base plate and pole, how to put this together without a frame. Let's put the clusters together now, and this is how I created the top. I used monofilament. You can also use Dacron arch line, which works great. And we're going to tie into the first one. Place the next one. Position your prints so that they're not right together. It makes it a lot prettier. I went up, over, under the ones below, and then pull on it and push on the knot to get it nice and taut. Now, if you have two of the same prints together or you want to move it to a different spot, this is the time to change it. It's beautiful balloon wrestling. Now we're going to add 5-inch organic to this. For 5-inch organic clusters, I'm going to use 2 at a time, but I'm not going to size them to the same size. I'm going to round them by pushing onto them. It makes a much prettier shape. And I'm going to let a little air out, and I really want this to be shiny, so I'm just going to temporarily hold this without tying it around my little finger and push this down into the end of the bulb and then wrap the two together and tie them off. 2 more. I'm looking for 4 different sizes, and this time I'm really going to make this reflex balloon really small. And as you can see, when I let some of the air out and make it this small, it's not as shiny. So what I'm going to do is wrap this one around my finger, squeeze the air down. Look how much shinier that is. Give it a twist, and then tie them together. Now we have 2 very shiny balloons. Wrap them together, and we're ready to place them onto the large cluster, column. I'm taking a 260 and tying it right to one of the clusters. And I'm tying the other end to this cluster. And now I'll show you how to wrap it in place. Simply stretch this out, pull it into the center, wrap it around, and pull it out where it looks best. Easy. Now, let me show you how to make the curls as these small accents that I added. To make the curls, I pre-inflate 260s to soften them just a little bit and make them easier to manipulate. Look how much bigger this one that has been pre-inflated is versus the one that hasn't been inflated yet. And now, to make the curl, I'm just going to hold the tip of it between my finger and thumb like this, stretch it and wrap it around my hand, my fingers first, then my hand, and down my wrist. I made sure there was no wrinkles or twists. That's important. And then inflate it. I let a little air out and tie it. If I want something a little tighter, I can just simply roll it onto itself and massage it a little bit. Look how much tighter that is. Now, I'm just going to wrap this right into the design to add just a little bit of fun. I have 2. I'm going to tie them together to make a duplet. And 1 I'm going to twist right into the design, and the other one just as an accent at the end. You can use just a touch of glue dashes or double-sided tape if you want to give it a very special position. Or just tuck it right in place. Final touches, globes from Betallic. They're beautiful, they're strong, and they look great in organic. The way to attach them is to use a 260, tie on the neck nice and tight, and now you can simply pull this into the design and wrap it in place. What a great touch. One last tip, if you want to fill in any spaces with a printed balloon or a cluster, it's easy to do. Just wrap it in place. That's the mechanics, and here's the application. Bigger, smaller, column, arch. Have fun with organics and Betallic.